How long has the Ten Commandments been in existence? Is this something that God only gave to Moses on Mount Sinai, or did it exist before the time? In this video, we are going to determine whether the Ten Commandments existed even before the earth was created, or only at Mount Sinai. If you've not subscribed yet to our channel, then do so now by clicking on the subscribe button, on the bell, and on all, you receive notifications when we upload new videos. Let's get back to our video. In our previous video that I uploaded up to our YouTube page, I showed you the great deception that is in the world in regards to the Ten Commandments. In this video, I want to show you that the Ten Commandments existed before the earth was created. We can already see this when we look at the attributes of God and the attributes of the law as explained within the Bible. I gave the details in the previous video that is exactly the same. God's character is the Ten Commandments explained and revealed to humanity. So let's ask the question, how long ago did the Ten Commandments exist? Let's start with the fall of Lucifer from heaven. The Bible tells us in 1 John chapter 3 and verse 4, whoever committeth sin transgresseth also the law, for the sin is the transgression of the law. So the Bible says sin is the transgression of the law. So we can just ask ourselves, is there still sin in the world today? The answer is yes. So therefore, God's law must still exist, because sin is the transgression of God's law, and this is the New Testament after Christ was crucified. After Christ resurrected. This is for the Gentiles. This is the message for you and me. Now listen to verse 8, 1 John chapter 3 and verse 8. He that committeth sin is of the devil, for the devil sinneth from the beginning. For this purpose the Son of God was manifested, that he might destroy the works of the devil. So the devil sinned from the beginning. When was this? While it was in heaven. He sinned against God by coveting the position of Christ, by wanting that which was not attributed to him. And that's what he coveted. He broke the 10th commandment. Revelation chapter 12 verse 7 tells us how he was cast out of heaven. And war broke out in heaven. Michael and his angels fought with the dragon and his angels fought. Verse 8. But they did not prevail, nor was a place found for them in heaven any longer. Verse 9. So the great dragon was cast out, that serpent of old called the devil and Satan, who deceives the whole world. He was cast to the earth, and his angels were cast out with him. So the devil was cast out before the earth was created. Then he had to come down to this earth when he deceived Adam and Eve, and he was bound to this earth when Jesus died upon the cross. If you want more information about that, you can go back to our videos in regards to the devil, where I explained to you that he was cast out before the earth was created. He could still access heaven before the cross, as we see in the story of Job, Job chapter 1 and 2. But after the cross, he is stuck on the earth and he can go nowhere else. And he sinned in heaven in the beginning, meaning he transgressed God's law in heaven, for God's law already existed in heaven. Genesis 3 verse 1. Now the serpent was more cunning than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made. And he said to the woman, has God indeed said, you shall not eat of every tree of the garden? So here we see the serpent is now upon the earth, cast out of heaven because he sinned, transgressed God's law in heaven. That serpent was cast out of heaven according to Revelation chapter 12. And here we find that devil, the serpent, in Genesis chapter 3, deceiving the woman. Did Adam and Eve sin? Did they transgress God's law? Let's go to 1 Timothy 2 and verse 14. And Adam was not deceived, but the woman being deceived fell into transgression. So here the Bible says that the woman transgressed God's law. She fell into transgression. Therefore, the law did not only exist in heaven, but it existed in the Garden of Eden. Then Adam and Eve had two children, Cain and Abel. They both had to bring an offering. They both had to worship God. And God expected of them a lamb and not the first fruits. There was a sign for Abel, but no sign for Cain. Cain then goes and kills Abel because Abel worshiped the way God expected him to worship. Abel was obedient and Cain wasn't. Cain lived by grace and not by grace and obedience. He felt like God will accept his offering because God is love and you are under grace, not under law. You know, obedience doesn't matter. But Abel showed that obedience to God does matter. God then gives a sign to Abel, no sign to Cain. Cain kills Abel, and then he says, well, people are going to kill me now. And God puts a mark upon Cain for the murder that he committed so that no one else would kill Cain then too. How did Cain know that he killed his brother? How did he know that this was wrong? Well, the Ten Commandments says, thou shalt not kill, the sixth commandment. What about Abraham? Did he keep the commandments before Mount Sinai? Genesis 26 and verse 5. Because Abraham obeyed my voice and kept my charge, my commandments, my statutes, and my laws. So Abraham obeyed God's commandments before Mount Sinai. All of those who were faithful to God obeyed his commandments. Noah, you can go through the genealogies, they all obeyed God's commandments. Then we get to Exodus chapter 15. Israel has come out of Egypt. This is before Mount Sinai. And God then tells them in Exodus 15 verse 26, if you diligently heed the voice of the Lord your God and do what is right in his sight, give ear to his commandments and keep all his statutes, I will put none of the diseases on you which I have brought on the Egyptians. So here God affirms what his requirements are. He wants them to obey his commandments. Why then did God only write it and speak it in Exodus 20 and write it later and gave it to the Israelites? It's so that they could see the rules of the covenant, what the foundation of the old covenant between God and Israel was. And it was the law of God as the foundation. And you would tell me, yeah, but what's the new covenant? Doesn't the law of God fall away? I'll still do a video about the old covenant versus the new covenant. And we would see that the foundation is exactly the same according to the scriptures. So here God speaks the commandments in Exodus chapter 20. Exodus 15, God already said to them, keep my commandments. It stays the same. What about Isaiah? Did Isaiah keep the commandments? Isaiah 48 and verse 18. Oh, that you had heeded my commandments. Then your peace would have been like a river, and your righteousness like the waves of the sea. Oh, we love to sing that hymn, peace like a river. How can we have peace like a river? When we obey God's commandments. That's how it happens. Then God promises us many blessings. He promises us peace when we walk within his will as revealed in the Ten Commandments. Think about David, the longest chapter in all of the Bible. Psalm 119. What is it about? It's about the Ten Commandments. Why? Because it's important to God. It is his character and he wants us to keep it. What about Daniel? Think about Daniel. Read the 12 chapters in the book of Daniel. You read nothing wrong about this man. Listen to what he says. And I prayed to the Lord my God and made confession and said, O Lord, great and awesome God, who keeps his covenant and mercy with those who love him and with those who keep his commandments. God keeps his covenant with those who obey him, those who do what is right in his sight. Now, I just want to say something. This is not something you can just inherently do in yourself. We are selfish by nature. But in Christ and through the infilling of his Holy Spirit, he empowers us to keep the commandments. Let's go to the New Testament. There's no doubt that the Old Testament teaches we need to keep the commandments of God and that the commandments was in existence before Satan fell to the earth. What about the New Testament? What did Jesus say? What is the fruit of your salvation? Meaning, what would happen now that you are saved? The commandments can't save you. But what happens when you are saved through the grace and blood of Jesus Christ? Let's go to John 14, verse 15. Jesus said, if you love me, keep my commandments. So Jesus said, the proof, the evidence that you love me is that you would walk within the Ten Commandments. That is your barrier. That is your protection, the Ten Commandments. And God expects us to obey him, to walk within it. And that is proof of our love to him. Let's jump to what Paul said in Romans 7 verse 12. Therefore, the law is holy and the commandment holy and just and good. And here Paul clearly explains when he says law what he means. He says the commandment. He's referring to the Ten Commandments when he says the law. And he says, it is holy, it is just, and good. So once again, this is after the cross, and Paul says, it is holy, just, and good. What does he say in 1 Corinthians 7, verse 19? Circumcision is nothing, and uncircumcision is nothing, but keeping the commandments of God is what matters. So Paul confirms what Solomon, the wisest man that's ever lived, said in Ecclesiastes 12, verse 13. Solomon said, fear God and keep his commandments. It's the whole duty of man. Paul says, you know, circumcision, uncircumcision, those things that they were arguing about in the law doesn't matter. What matters is keep the commandments of God, for it is holy, it is just, and it's good. And what is he referring to when he says it? Well, he said it in Romans 7. He's referring to the law, the Ten Commandments. What about the brother of Jesus, James? What did he say about the commandments? James 2, verse 10 and 11. Whoever shall keep the whole law and yet stumble in one point, he is guilty of all. So that's very clear. If you think that it doesn't matter if you keep the commandments or not, he says if you break one out of the 10, you are guilty of all 10. Listen to what he says in verse 11. What is he talking about? For he who said, do not commit adultery, also said, do not murder. Now, if you do not commit adultery, but you do murder, you have become a transgressor of the law. You remember Adam and Eve in the beginning? Eve transgressed against God. Sin is a transgression of the law. And yet James also says, if you break the Ten Commandments, you are a transgressor of the law. So when James said the law, if you stumble in one point, you're guilty of all. He explains what he's talking about. And he quotes as an example, 2 out of the 10, saying, what does it help? You do not commit adultery, but you do murder. Therefore, you're guilty of all. What about the last day people? What the book of Revelation called the saints or the remnant? Revelation 12, verse 17. And the dragon was wroth with the woman and went to make war with the remnant of her seed, which keep the commandments of God and have the testimony of Jesus Christ. Why is the devil angry at the remnant? Why does the devil want to attack God's people? Well, the Bible tells us they've got two attributes that stands out. They keep the commandments of God and they have the testimony of Jesus Christ. They don't just have Jesus and His grace. They have the commandments too. My friends, this is what the Bible says. It's not what my church says. It's not what my ministry says. I'm quoting Scripture. Now listen to Revelation 14. Revelation 14 is the center of all of the book of Revelation. It's where the great controversy between good and evil takes place, especially verse chapters 12 to 14, but chapter 14 is very important. Chapter 14, Jesus comes. Verse 14, He comes. There are these three angels' messages that prepares the world for the coming of Jesus. And the result of the three angels' messages, when you heed the messages, is then verse 12. Verse 11 talks about those who receive the mark of the beast, they are lost. And those who are the saints. Listen to verse 12. Here is the patience of the saints. Here are those who keep the commandments of God and have the faith of Jesus. So once again, it's Christ and the commandments. The book of Revelation, the final book of the Bible that explains the end time, says God's final people will have three attributes. One of them is mentioned twice. Keep the commandments of God. The other two, the testimony of Jesus and the faith of Jesus. I'll still do videos on those in the future. So the Bible says the remnant, the saints, will keep the commandments of God, all 10 of them. What about those who will enter the kingdom? Revelation chapter 22 and verse 14. Blessed are those who do His commandments, that they may have the right to the tree of life and may enter in through the gates into the city. Which city? Well, Revelation 21 and 22 tells us it's the New Jerusalem. It is the heavenly city that God brings down upon this earth. He recreates the heavens and the earth. And then He says, those who enter the city are those who keep the commandments. My friends, this is vitally important. This is no joke. This is no light thing that has just been nailed to the cross. This is the character of God that people are tampering with. And therefore, it's a great deception to teach people to break God's law. It doesn't matter. You just need the grace of Christ. My friends, we do need the grace of Christ. We do need to be saved through faith in His blood and His resurrection only. But once I'm saved, He aligns my will with His will. And His will, God's will, is expressed in the Ten Commandments. Who are we to tell Him what His will is? We just walk in it by faith.